What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to another episode of MZ Talks Boxing. I am your host, MZ. Let's talk about it. Now, many people are looking at the Tyson Fury COVID situation as what it is, a ploy, a way to get out of the fight. I have been one that said Fury, in my opinion, is really afraid of Wilder. He's afraid of Wilder's power, and he's afraid of the fact that Wilder stood up to the best that Fury could dish out. Whether you want to call it cheating, or whether you want to call it Fury having a great showing. Either way, in the two fights that Fury and Wilder has met, has just confirmed, in my opinion, it has confirmed to Fury that he really doesn't have anything for Wilder. The first fight he told you, oh, just boxing, I can't beat Wilder. People try to say that, oh, Fury was robbed. The United States robbed him out of his win. When there weren't even any United States judges on that first fight card. So, seeing that he didn't win that way, he decided to step his cheat game up and add another tactic to it. People are saying that his gloves weighed the same amount. Yeah, but I believe one of the gloves had more padding in it because he was still hitting with the palm of his left hand with the left glove, which didn't flop as much, and maybe that's because he had a little more padding in it to sit, stiffen it up. Maybe that's where the padding from the right glove went, where it has the dent, where it looks like something's wrong with it. But forget all about glove gate, and floppy gloves, and no padding in the glove. The fact is, Fury couldn't defeat Wilder and put Wilder down without Mark Breland throwing in the towel. He already told you he can't outbox Wilder and win because he's tried that already and it doesn't work. Now seeing that Wilder is not only agitated, aggravated, and really out for blood and revenge because he feels that you cheated him, no one has come out and dispelled that myth. They just want to say, oh, it's preposterous and try to make jokes. That's the reason ESPN and everybody else is not speaking on it. Because if YouTubers could look at a fight that's been recorded and see floppy gloves and dented gloves, well, what do you think ESPN sees with million-dollar cameras and the highest of technology watching the fight, watching it in replay, watching it in slow motion? They see what everyone else sees. They're just playing as if they don't. That way, they don't have to remark on it. If they don't acknowledge the fact except by saying, oh, there, the fans are being preposterous, the fans are stupid. They're calling us stupid because we believe our eyes and not the bullshit that they're trying to sell us. What do you think? And if you've been here before, thank you for coming again. I'm going to ask that you drop a like, drop a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Hit the bell icon just in case you're not subscribed so you can be notified when I drop more content. MZ out.